This semester's really stressing me out.
What about the project, dude?
Oh, you mean the one for Kunamaya, man?
Yeah, bros.
How the hell are we supposed to do a 30-minute TV show?
Far out. Maybe we should ask the rest of the group.
I dig it. Let me give them a call.
So that's good. I think that'll be a good start.
Mm-hmm. That would probably, yeah.
The colors are nice. Oh. Oh, what is that?
Too hairy.
Too hairy.
Yeah.
We're gonna go to the next one.
Yeah. Oh, maybe that'll work.
Too much biting.
Oh.
Okay. What's up, groovy girls?
Hello. Darling, I can't just take it.
Who is it?
It's part of our group.
Yeah.
Yo, dog, we really need help on this project. We have no idea what the hell we're doing.
They won't help with the project.
We asked them to do one thing, which is just to come up with a topic. How hard is that?
I'm gonna put them on speaker.
Uh-huh.
What if we did a documentary on dogs?
Yeah.
Where would we get bugs from?
True.
No. No, it's not happening. We're not doing bugs, so get that out of your head. Anyway.
Okay.
What if we did like a short, like horror, like TV show kind of thing?
That feels too cheesy.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, we only have 30 minutes.
Alright.
So. Too much.
Cool.
Too much.
Mm-hmm.
Like something surrounding time?
Like, yeah. What is that?
Oh.
What about time?
Okay.
Hello?
Yeah.
Hello?
Alright. Yeah. Oh. Okay. Yeah. Uh-huh. Ooh. Awesome.
So, what did the girls say?
I think that'll be a waste of time.
Ooh! That was funny!
Okay.
Oh my gosh, that. What about decades?
Awesome.
Yes? I think that'd be really cool.
That'd be awesome.
I think we should just do that.
Okay.
That's the idea!
That's better than the bugs.
They said we should do a decade show.
Far out.
Bangin'.
A bottle of Coca-Cola.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Tompkins.
strike, pour it in. Cream butter. To stir is to mix food materials with a circular motion. Your frosting recipe may call upon you to perform the test of the soft ball stage.
Most men would have a difficult time if they were to change jobs with wife, mother, or girlfriend. The homemaker walks miles every day from sink to icebox, from cupboard to stove, and from kitchen to dining table. Here we see the perfect frail housewife, Patricia, creating a marvelous meal for her husband, Richard. Yes, the honeymoon is over for Richard as the man of the house heads back to work. This bliss is also over for the housewife as she begins her task of preparing her husband's meal for the day. Can she prepare Richard's favorite dishes, just like his mother used to make? What would he like for dinner? Perhaps a simple sandwich. Perfect. All you have to do is follow the recipe. This is going to be easy. Just look how evenly she spreads the creamy peanut butter. Won't Richard be delighted? Won't Richard be surprised? No! No, Patricia! Your sandwich didn't come out so well. Because you misunderstood a term in your cookbook. Your cookbook will provide you with many definitions that pertain to cooking alone. If she had only looked at the glossary before she prepared that sandwich. But wait a minute. There is still time to make another sandwich before Richard returns home for lunch. It will be right this time and he will never know the difference. Yes, now Patricia has learned the proper way to cook by using terms from the cookbook. And Richard will never know she ruined her first sandwich.
Look at our new RCA Victor portable radio. Came through without a chip.
How do I read this? What do you mean I have to continue this story on A5? Oh wait, I have an idea.
Approximately, I spend about 5 hours on my phone.
I spend 6 hours a day. It's hard to determine a percentage, but it is believed that people can spend up to 5 hours a day on their cell phones.
You know how decades ago people used to write love letters? Well, that's changed.
Hasbro makes great toys. It's fun to play with Hasbro.
Are you tired of having to rewind your rented tapes before returning them to the store? Is the audio and picture quality of your home video system getting to you? Well, what if I told you that could all be a thing of the past? Introducing DVDs, a brand new way to watch your favorite movies.
And you'll never have to worry about those bulky tapes again.
I won't!
No, and being the size of your standard CD, DVDs are easily portable.
Radical!
With video and sound quality 2 times better than your standard VHS.
Holy cow! The picture is sharp!
Don't even bother paying for tickets at the movie theater. DVD now gives you the full theater experience from the comfort of your own home. With DVDs, you now have access to a ton of new features. Watch the behind-the-scenes footage, choose which language you'd like to watch the film in, and even watch the film in widescreen.
A director's cut? That's tight, dog!
And if you call the number below, we will send you a brand new DVD player for the extremely low price of
$249.99. Only $249.99? Sign me up!
And that's not all.
That's not all.
And for our first 100 callers, we will send you 3 free DVD titles of your choice. A $60 value that you'll get for free!
Tubular, I'll call right now.
Just call 1-800-DVD-PLAYER, and this could all be yours.
My DVD player has changed my life. Let it change yours, too.
For the low price of $249.99, all of this can be yours. We'll even throw in 3 of your favorite films on DVD for free. Just pay shipping and processing. Call now.
If you want shoes with lots of pep, get Keds Kids.
As a millennial, I took it upon myself to try to evaluate what's so wrong with our generation and why they're so mad at us. And then I pretty much realized that we're just existing. We're not really contributing anything to society. We're lazy. We're really entitled. And we want to make a lot of money and have free education, but we're not really willing to put in the work. We're more divided as a country than ever before. And I think our generation actually has a lot to do with that.
Rapper Kendrick Lamar raised some eyebrows last night when he opened the BET Awards singing on top of a vandalized cop car.
When you know we've been hurt. Low, looking at the world like, where do we go? Hit her, and we hate Popo. When they kill us dead on the street for sure. Hit her, I'm at the preacher's door. My knees getting weak, and my gun might blow. But we go be our...
Did you catch that? Lamar stated his views on police brutality with that line in the song, quote, and we hate the Popo. Want to kill us in the street for sure.
To say the least, this not helpful at all. This is why I say that hip-hop has done more damage to young African-Americans than racism in recent years.
The heart of liberalism now in America, the heart of it, is race. Everything's about race.
Right.
And how the white privileged people are the devil.
Yep, yep.
And here we go. This is another example.
These spoiled, smug, ignorant punks, dweeb-splaining their... shaming of white people, essentially, is what they're doing.
One of the most famous rap stars in the world. You know, 2 Chainz, first of all, thank you for being with us. You're a star. So many people, so many teens, so many young adults look up to you. I don't get it. I mean, I've seen video of you smoking a big fat doobie. I mean, I've read your lyrics. I know what you say in your songs. Other of your lyrics advocate a different kind of lifestyle, a different kind of lifestyle that I don't think you would want little children exposed to. I mean, do you have children?
I have 2 beautiful little girls, and I'm a great father. I just feel like, you know, everybody should basically take care of their own. You have kids too as well, right? So it's about governing your own household. It's about taking care of your own property. It's about having some kind of structure.
You've been criticized for using offensive language in lyrics and songs. It doesn't seem to bother you. Why do you use offensive language? I mean, do you use that for effect? In other words, it's effective to say that. Or do you enjoy saying it, or is it natural to you?
Yeah, it's just pretty natural. I don't really think twice on it, I guess. I don't know. It's just words, man.
Does the society object to it?
Some, like people who live in caves and like are pretty bored.
Do you use the N-word?
Yes.
Now, that's an offensive word to
some people. To many people.
And in what terms do you use it?
I don't know, man. See, like, people have to understand, I grew up in a different time.
Thank you, thank you, thank you. Far too kind. Woo! Yeah.
Ready?
On Sunbeam Energy, they sure do enjoy life.
butt like this. Well then, keep watching. Hit it. Come on, guys. Welcome to the hippest 80s workout video you'll ever own. Keep jogging, ladies, and all you folks at home, join in too. Are we ready?
Yeah!
Are you sure?
Yeah!
Okay! We're gonna go to the right and in, and right and in, and right and in. And then we switch the sides and the left. And in. See, this is really toning your calves. Now we're gonna go up and down and up and down. Now we're gonna take a double time, ladies. Are you ready? Time to hit the floor. If you have your resist band, go and grab it. If you didn't, you can order ours off our VHS for $4.99. Ladies, you got your resist band? Okay, it's time to do some legs. We ready, girls?
Yeah.
Let's go. And one, and two, and three, and four, and five, and six. Yeah, you feeling it?
Yeah.
Okay, ladies at home, you feeling the burn too? Yeah, that's just what I wanted to hear. Are you sweating? Good, because I sure am like a hooker in church. Thanks everyone at home for working out with us. I hope you had a great time. Make sure you rewind that tape and do it every day this week. Bye-bye.
Is the new Band-Aid plastic strip with new Super Stick.
Hurt finger.
How are you fixed for blades? You better catch.
Jimmy played baseball all afternoon and he didn't feel like walking home, so he decided to thumb a ride. He'd done it 100 times before, and he didn't think anything was unusual when the driver struck up a friendly conversation. In fact, he seemed like a real nice guy. He asked Jimmy if he played baseball in the park often. Jimmy told him they practiced 3 times a week and played a rival group on Friday afternoon. The stranger was a good listener, too. What Jimmy didn't know was that Ralph was sick, a sickness that was not visible like smallpox, but no less dangerous and contagious, a sickness of the mind. You see, Ralph was a homosexual, a person who demands an intimate relationship with members of their own sex.
This morning, the Supreme Court recognized that the Constitution guarantees marriage equality. Progress on this journey often comes in small increments. Sometimes 2 steps forward, 1 step back, held by the persistent effort of dedicated citizens. It's a victory for gay and lesbian couples who have fought so long for their basic civil rights. We've made real progress in advancing equality for LGBT Americans in ways that were unimaginable not too long ago.
I'm gay. I'm gay.
Thank you.
See, there's this one teensy little complication. Actually, not so teensy.
I'm hungry? Gay.
What?
What? Are you
I'm
hungry?
Gay.
What?
According to this repeated nationwide survey, more doctors smoke Camels than any other cigarette.
Hanging out down the street.